press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
We are starting a debate of a very important chapter, chemical equilibrium. And I'll be discussing here about 15 to 16 questions of this. This is our first remaining class with respect to chemical equilibrium. So total of 32 numericals and 35 numericals will be solved. From chemical equilibrium it will be 16, and from ionic equilibrium it will be 16. So we will break this equilibrium into two parts, chemical equilibrium and ionic equilibrium respectively. So this is for NEET and JEE exams, for first revision, so that you can look onto the revision notes quite carefully and have a look on the discussion that I'm going to do here. So this material you will be getting, and I'll be starting question number one with respect to chemical equilibrium. So question number one for us is, for which of the following reaction the degree of dissociation alpha, so we have degree of dissociation alpha and the Kp. So question is, for which of the following given reactions alpha and Kp are related as Kp equals to 4 alpha square P divided by 1 minus alpha square. So we have the reactions given, children. So first one is N2O4 gives us twice NO2. Keep it in mind, this is a gaseous phase reaction. Means N2O4 and NO2 both are in gaseous phase. Second, N2 plus 3 moles of hydrogen, gaseous phase only, gives you 2 moles of ammonia. All are in the gaseous phase. Third one is PCl3 plus Cl2 gives us PCl5. And the fourth reaction is H2 plus I2 gives us twice HI. So in these four reactions, all are in gaseous phase reactions here. So all are in gaseous phase reactions. So I have cut short that thing. So all are in gaseous phase reactions. Now, our question is, Kp is related to P. So alpha and P are related to Kp by this equation. Now you can see, if you go with a direct assessment, you can see P is in the numerator. That means when you are solving for the Kp value, we know, when we solve for Kp value for any gaseous phase equation, Kp will be equal to what? Pressure of products raised by the power equal to their coefficient divided by the pressure exerted by the reactants raised by the power equal to their coefficients. Now looking on, if I take any reaction out of this into play, it will be simple to understand. Because pressure is in numerator, correct or not? That means when you have products more than reactants, only then P will be coming in numerator. If delta N is 0, P will not be involved. Let me take into consideration. In this delta N, what is delta N? Change in the number of moles of gaseous phase reaction. Delta N here is 0, right? If I write for this one, what is Kp equal to? Tell me. Kp will be equal to P of Hi divided by P of H2 into P of I2, yes, raised by the power equal to their stoichiometric coefficients. For this it is 2, so there is no stoichiometric coefficient to H2 and I2 respectively. Clear, children? Now according to Dalton's law, in a mixture of a gases, if you want to find out the pressure of Hi, then pressure of Hi will be mole fraction of Hi into P total. Pressure of H2 will be mole fraction of H2 into P total. And obviously I2 will be also mole fraction of I2 into P total. Now have a look. Kp equals to PHI. That means PHI is equal to mole fraction of HI into P. So I will write that down. Mole fraction of HI, yes, into P raised by the power 2 divided by mole fraction of H2 into P into mole fraction of I2 into P. Correct or not? It will come P square. This will come P square. P square and P square will cancel. What is delta here? Delta N is 0. So pressure is not playing any part at all. When pressure does not play any part, volume will also not play any part. Correct or not? Have a look. Pressure is in the numerator. So here delta L is 0, pressure is playing, not playing any part. So this cannot be our correct option. According to logic only, what is delta N here? Minus 1. That means there will be more pressure term in denominator, not in numerator. So we have P in the numerator, not in denominator. So what is delta N for this one? Minus 1. What is delta N for this one? Minus 2. What is delta N for this one? Plus 1. So correct option will be first one. If you want to cross check it as well, we can solve it as well. Have a look. Look on the reaction. N2O4 gas gives us twice NO2. Right, children? So initial concentration, concentration after time t, equilibrium concentration. What is initial concentration here? Let us suppose 1 mole. This will be 0 initially. Concentration after time t, 1 minus alpha. This will be 2 alpha. Now equilibrium concentration, 1 minus alpha plus 2 alpha. That makes it 1 plus alpha. So these are the total number of moles in equilibrium. Right? So what is Kp? Kp will be equal to what? P of NO2 raised by the power 2. What is pressure of NO2? Mole fraction of NO2. And what is mole fraction of NO2? Number of moles of NO2 divided by total number of moles. So what is the number of moles of NO2? 2 alpha. So it will be 2 alpha divided by 1 plus alpha into P raised by the power 2 divided by P of, according to equilibrium equation, P of what? H2. So what is the concentration, P of N2O4. What is the number of moles of N2O4 after some time? So that will be 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha into P. Correct or not? Let us not solve this term out at all. So if you want to solve it also, so it is P square, right? It will become what? It will become 4 alpha square. 4 alpha square. It will become 1 plus alpha whole square, right? Into P. I'll just cut short it out. Divided by. Will there be any P term in the denominator? No. So 4 alpha square P. You got 4 alpha square P divided by 1 minus alpha square. So correct option will be option 1. Did you get it clear? So the basic thing is, children, check for delta N. If delta N is positive, pressure term will be in numerator, but volume term will be in denominator. This should be understood. Because pressure and volume are inversely proportional. Also, if delta N is 0, then pressure and volume will play no part. You can see that here easily. Pressure is getting cancelled, volume will also get cancelled accordingly. So children, when you are solving questions in equilibrium equation with respect to pressure and volume, and you have to write molar concentration in equilibrium equation, remember, if delta N is 0, pressure has no role to play, volume has no role to play. Am I clear? So the correct option will be option 1. Clear, children? Yes. So we can go with question number next. So question number 2 will be, so make a proper note of this thing and understand what exactly I have done here. Because already we have profusely discussed the concept of equilibrium. So I'll be solving out the questions and revising the concepts through questions itself here in these discussions. Right? Good. Now, let us see next question. Question number 2. Question number 2 for us is, in a chemical equilibrium, the rate constant of backward reaction is 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 4. So rate constant for backward reaction is, so this is question number 2, 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 4. Rate constant of backward reaction. And equilibrium constant is 1.5. And equilibrium constant is 1.5. Okay, good. So the rate constant of forward reaction, so what will be rate constant of forward reaction? We have to find it out. A very simple thing. We know equilibrium constant is the ratio of rate constant of forward reaction by rate constant of backward reaction. So we can write K equals to KF by KB. Yes or no? So what are we searching for? KF. So what will be KF equal to? KF will be equal to K into KB. So what is K given to you, children? 1.5. And what is KB given to you? 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 4. When you look on the options given are 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. This is option 1. So option 2 is 15 into 10 to the power minus 4. Option 3 for you is 1.125 into 10 to the power minus 3. And option 4 is 9.0 into 10 to the power minus 4. When you solve it out, children, you will get correct option as 1.125 into 10 to the power minus 3. Now, you might be thinking, where from I got this K equals to K by KV? Now, if you look in chemical equilibrium very precisely and properly, we have discussed a dissociation constant KA. We have discussed ionic product KW. We have discussed KB. We have discussed the dissociations of different acids which are polyprotic in nature. We have discussed equilibrium constant also. Just to revise it out, I will give you a just small idea about this. How do I reach the conclusion? Say, A plus B gives C plus D, right? This is rate constant for forward reaction. This is rate constant for backward reaction. Before equilibrium, we know, according to law of mass action, rate of a reaction directly proportional to molar concentration of A, molar concentration of B. So I'll write rate of forward reaction. What about backward reaction? It is law of chemical equilibrium. Rate of backward reaction directly proportional to molar concentration of C, molar concentration of D. I finish the proportional, I write equality term. So rate of forward reaction equals to Kf and rate of backward reaction equals to Kb, where Kf and Kb are rate constants of forward and backward reaction. At equilibrium, what happens? Molar concentration, that is rate of forward reaction and backward reaction, will be same. So what will happen at that time? Rf equals to Rb. That technically means KfAb equals to KbCd. So if I want to write Kf by Kb, what will be this equal to? Molar concentration of Cd divided by molar concentration of Ab raised by the power equal to their stoichiometric coefficients. So what is molar concentration of product by reactant equal to? Equilibrium constant, that is Kf by Kb. This is where I talked about the conclusion. This is equilibrium constant, K forward by K backward. Clear, children? So this is a direct assessment of the question. You can solve it out by this equation respectively. Clear? Good. Let us see question number next. So our next question, children, is for a reaction, 2A plus B gives 2C. We have a reaction. Question number 3. 2A plus B is in equilibrium with 2C. Good. So for this, equilibrium constant has been given X. Right. Next, we are asked equilibrium constant for, so we are asked equilibrium constant for C gives us A plus half of B. So for this, we have to find out equilibrium constant. Correct? Options are, what are the options given, children? We have been given X. Option 2 is X by 2. Option 3 for you is 1 by root x. And option 4 for you is, children, root x. Now, have a look on the question. If you look on the basic equation, equilibrium constant given is what? X. Now, this reaction, the first reaction, in the second one has been reversed. So, for this reaction, which has been reversed, not only has been it reversed, but it has been reduced to half. What are the logics? Any reaction happening in forward direction, if equilibrium constant is A, when you reverse the same reaction, equilibrium constant becomes 1 by A. If you reverse the same reaction and make it half, then the new equilibrium constant will be 1 by root of that. If you multiply it by n times, then the equilibrium constant will be raised by the power n. If the chemical equilibrium is carried out in multiple steps, then the net equilibrium constant will be the multiple of individual equilibrium constant. These are 4-5 basic rules that we already know in equilibrium. Right, children? Good. So 2a plus b gives 2c. What's equilibrium constant? X for this reaction. We are reversing it. Once you reverse it, what it will be? 2c gives you 2a plus b. Let us represent new equilibrium constant by k dash. K dash will be 1 by x. That means 1 by k, technically that will be 1 by x. Correct or not? But this reaction, is it the same reaction, reverse it or reduce it to half? Reduce it to half. Because this is C. How many times is C? Twice. It is reduced to half or not? So technically this reaction is half of the original reaction. Yes or no? So what is the stoichiometric coefficient now? 1 by 2 of the original reaction. Then k dash dash will become 1 by x, but root of that. Because it is 1 by 2. Correct, children? So the correct option for this will be 1 by root x. So correct option will be option 3. Yes? Are you getting the points clearly, children? Excellent. Let's move on to the next question. So be careful what I am discussing out here. So you need to keep all the things into play here so that you can solve questions quite easily. It's all about understanding and writing the right values. Yes, children? Very good. Let's have a look on question number 4. XY2 dissociates as. So we have XY2 gas is dissociating as XY gas plus Y gas. Very good. Initial pressure of XY2 is 600 mmHg. So what is the initial pressure of XY2? So initial pressure P of XY2, initial pressure is how much? 600 mmHg. Very good. Then the total pressure at equilibrium is 800 mmHg. So P total given to you is 800 mmHg. That means the total pressure exerted by the mixture of the gases at equilibrium is 800. And starting, we have taken the pressure of XY2 as 600. Because this is gas, so we have taken into consideration as pressure. Otherwise, we could have taken concentration. Excellent. Then, assuming volume of the system to remain constant. So, according to question, delta V is not changing. So, delta V equals to 0. No change in volume at all. And volume is not changing. Pressure will not play any part as well. Good. The value of Kp is... Our question is to find out the value of Kp. Good, children? So let us write the options. Options are 50. First option, 50. Second option is 100. Third option is 20. And fourth option is 400. So we need to solve this question. I repeat question. XY2 dissociates as XY2 gas gives us XY gas plus Y gas. Initial pressure of XY2 is 600 mmHg. The total pressure at equilibrium is 800 mmHg. Assuming volume of system to remain constant, the value of Kp is. Options have been already given. Let us see this question. Now, here we have the equation. XY2 gives us XY plus Y. So, what is the initial concentration, children, in terms of pressure? 600, right? This is 0, this is 0 at the start of the reaction. Once dissociation happens, concentration after time t, it will be 600 minus P. This will be P, this will be P. Because some of the moles of XY2 are converted to XY and Y respectively. So the total pressure that is exerted now at equilibrium, we have 600 minus P plus P plus P, right? Equals to P total. How much is P total exerted? 800 mmHg. So these two will be off. So what will be P equal to, children? P will be equal to 800 minus 600. Yes. So what is P equal to total? 200. Am I clear? Now what are we asked to find out? What are we asked to find out? We are asked to find out Kp. So what will be Kp equal to? Have a look on the equation. Kp will be equal to XY. Pressure of XY into pressure of Y. Divided by XY2. How much is XY2? Remaining at equilibrium. 600 minus P. Am I clear or not? So how much is P you got? 200. So this will be in denomination. It will be 600 minus P. Tell me, children, how much is P? 200. So 200 into 200 divided by 600 minus 200. So it will be how much? 40000, right? It will be how much? 400. Yes. Can we solve it out now? What's the answer? Very good. So answer will be, so these two will be cancelling off. So answer will be 100. So the correct option is option 2. Did you get the point clearly? Every one of you. So have a look on the ideas quite carefully. So here P total is already given. P total is that, what does P total mean here? P total will mean the pressure that has been exerted now in the mixture, which contains all the three at equilibrium. Because before equilibrium, the total pressure was only due to what? XY2. Now the pressure is due to XY also and due to Y also. Am I clear or not? If you use Mohr fraction equation also, you'll be able to get the same answer respectively for this. Because Mohr fraction equation, you have to take total number of moles in equilibrium into consideration and individual pressures as well. Am I clear with the thought? So the correct option for this will be 100. Right? Right or not? Excellent. Move on to the next question. We have question number 5 now. Everyone, be careful the way I'm solving the questions. Right. So, write on the next question, children. The next question we have is hydrogen A moles and iodine B moles. So we have the general reaction, what? H2 plus I2 gives twice HI. So we started with what moles of H2? So initial concentration H2 A moles and I2 B moles. Initially HI will not be there because it has not combined and result in the formation of HI. Once equilibrium starts to set up, we can write A minus X, this will be B minus X, this will be 2X. Clear? Because there are two moles of HI that are made. Right. Okay. So, total number of moles at equilibrium is, our question is, what is the total number of moles at equilibrium? So, option one for you is, children, A plus B plus 2X. Option two is, A minus B into B minus 2x. Option 3 is A plus B. And option 4 is, children, A plus B minus x. These are the four options for this question. So at equilibrium, initial concentration, concentration after time t, initial concentration means time equals to 0. So when time equals to 0 seconds, when time equals to t seconds, when I say t seconds, I mean to say when reaction has started. And when time equals to equilibrium seconds, means when equilibrium is set up. So what are the total number of moles that we have after dissociation? What are they? A minus X, then plus B minus X. Why I'm writing it? Because they have combined it out. So from H to X, from I to X, and they have combined and result in the formation of 2X. So you got A minus X plus B minus X plus 2X. Because all these moles will be in combination now. That makes minus x makes it minus 2x. It will be cancelled with plus 2x. So this will cancel off. So total number of moles at equilibrium will be A plus B. So correct option for us will be option 3. Am I clear the statement, children? Excellent. Did you get it clearly? So this is quite simple. So you can use for this the rule so far I have been using. That's called as ICE rule. What is that called as? ICE rule. I initial concentration, time equals to 0 seconds. Concentration at time t means after the reaction has started, and e is the equilibrium concentration. This is the time when equilibrium is set up. So there will be no more changes in the measurable properties of a system like pressure, concentration, temperature, volume and other things. They will remain constant. Because what do we say equilibrium is? Equilibrium is a state of a system where the measurable properties of a system remain constant. They don't change with the passage of time. Only then we come to know that there is equilibrium setup. And also you should remember, there are two types of equilibrium, static and dynamic. Static equilibrium, once set done, there will be no more changes at all. But in dynamic equilibrium, things will be happening. But our apparent eye, there will be no change at all. Right? Good. Correct, children. Let's move on to next question. What's the question? 1 mole of NO2 and 2 moles of CO are enclosed in a 1 liter vessel to attain the following equilibrium. Yes. So we have question number, 6. 1 mole of, we have the reaction NO2 gas plus CO, which is also gas, is in equilibrium with NO plus, which is also gas, CO2. Correct? They are enclosed in 1 liter vessel. Anyway, volume will not matter for us. Why? Because delta N is 0. So when delta N is 0, we know Kp equals to Kc RT delta N. What is delta N here? 0. So remember, Kp will be equal to Kc for this equation. Pressure will play no role, volume will play no role. Right? And when you look in Lichelieu's principle, pressure and volume will play no role on this reaction at all because number of moles on both sides are same. Excellent. It was estimated that at equilibrium, 25% of initial amount of CO is consumed. So at equilibrium, 25% of CO has been consumed. How much? 25%. So 25% of CO consumed means 25 by 100 into number of initial moles of what? CO. That will be very simple. Because of the initial amount, 25% has been used. Right. Let's have a look on the equation more carefully, children. So our options are, our question is the equilibrium constant Kp. What will be equilibrium constant Kp? So our options are, children, what are the options? 1, option 2 is half, option 3 is 1/4, and option 4 is 1/3. These are the questions, these are the options given us.
Clear, children?
Yes. So according to the reaction, I will write it once more. NO2 plus CO gives us NO plus CO2. According to given question, how many moles of NO2 I have started with? 1 mole. How many moles of CO I have started with? 2 moles. Now this is initial concentration, right? 1 mole, 2 moles. How many moles? 0, 0. Clear? After some time, how much of CO is consumed? 25%. We don't know how much that is, right? So we can write concentration after time t. 1 minus, 2 minus, it is x. This is also x. Very good. Further, we have to calculate Kp for this, right? Now, equilibrium concentration for this number of moles will be 1 minus x, 2 minus x, x, x. If you sum it off, what it will be? 1 minus x, 2 minus x, x, x. We will calculate Kp. So what is Kp equal to, children? What is this x? Amount used, is it or not? So how much is the number of moles, initial moles of CO? 2. Yes. So initial moles of CO is 2. So CO consumed is how much? 25/100 × 2. That makes it 50/100. That makes it how much? 1/2. 1/2 means 0.5. So how much is x for you? How much is x? 0.5. Here? 0.5. Here? 1.5. Here? 0.5. So remaining moles from NO2 will be how much? 0.5. Because NO2 at equilibrium will be 1 minus x. That is 1 minus 0.5. That will be 0.5. So I'll write 0.5. How much this one? 1.5. How much this one? 0.5. How much this one? 0.5. What am I calculating? Kp. So tell me, what will be Kp equal to? So Kp will be equal to the molar concentration of products by reactants. Why I said molar concentration, although I have gases? Because here Kp equals to Kc. So I can calculate either Kp or Kc. Values will be same. So what will be Kc equal to? Tell me. 0.5. Oh, that is NO. How much of CO2? 0.5 divided by how much of NO2? 0.5 into how much of CO? 1.5. These two will be off or not? So 0.5 divided by 1.5 will make it 1/3. So the correct option will be option 3rd. Sorry, this is 4th option will be the correct option. That's 1/3. Am I clear with the thought, children? Clear here? It's very simple to calculate out. Because 25% consumed means both are same moles, right? So 25% from this, but how many moles are there? 2. So remaining moles is 1.5. How many moles of NO2 you took? 1. So remaining mole will be 0.5 only. Clear with the thought? So correct option will be 1/3, right? Let us see few more questions from this. This needs to be seen and this needs to be written. Chemical equilibrium, and as we know, we are solving MCQs of chemical equilibrium. So we have one question with respect to Legendre's principle. This will be question number 9. Given the reaction, a reaction is given to us. A reaction is 2x, this is question number 9 of the series. 2x, this is gas, plus y gas gives us Z gas plus 80 kilocalories of heat. Which combination of pressure and temperature gives the highest yield of Z? Our question is, what should be the combination of pressure and temperature which will give us maximum yield of Z? options are 1000 atmospheres and 500 degrees centigrade. Option 2 is 500 atmospheres and 500 degrees centigrade. Option 3 is 1000 atmospheres and 100 degrees centigrade. And option 4 is 500 atmospheres and 100 degrees centigrade. These are the four options given. So question is, which combination of pressure and temperature gives the highest yield of Z? So our question is very simple. We want the reaction to proceed in which direction? Forward direction. Correct? So in Liechti-Lehr's principle, what's a basic rule? Basic rule is a system which is in equilibrium and is subject to have a change in the measurable properties like pressure, temperature and concentration, it will always oppose the change trying to produce it. So we want more yield of Z. So first of all, we have to decide what is this reaction. You can see that easily. Delta H for this will be negative. That technically means the reaction is exothermic. Clear, children? And we already know in equilibrium, what is that? Endothermic reactions are favored by increase of temperature and exothermic reactions are favored by decrease of temperature. You can understand that why. Because when we decrease the temperature, system will try to keep it constant. And in order to keep it constant, the direction of the reaction should be in the direction where heat is evolved out. Clear or not? So forward direction is exothermic, yes or no? So decreasing temperature favors which? Exothermic, and increasing temperature favors endothermic. Because if you increase temperature, system tries to decrease it. Decrease of temperature can occur by absorbing it, right? So there'll be no change in the surroundings at all. Clear? So temperature should be less. Now, out of these cases, there are only two options where temperature is very less. Now, does pressure play a part? Yes. Because in this case, delta N equals to, you have how many moles here? One mole. One minus, how many moles are there? Three. So that will be minus two. That means in the forward direction, number of moles are decreasing or increasing? Decreasing. That means when the reaction proceeds in forward direction, pressure will decrease. So our application should be increase of pressure, because system will try to go in the direction where to decrease the pressure. So how many moles you have here? Three moles. How many moles you have here? One mole. If you increase pressure, on which side pressure will be decreased? Why? The number of moles will be less. So where are number of moles less? Towards forward direction. So the conditions are increase of pressure and decrease of temperature. Out of these options, you can see out 100 degrees centigrade, 100 degrees centigrade. These are the two possible options. But here pressure is more. So option 3 will be the correct option according to Liechti-Lehr's principle. Is it clear, children? Right. Good. Let's move on to the next question. So I will be finishing only chemical equilibrium first. So then we will move in our next class for ionic equilibrium. Right. Now we have next question. Question number 10. So what is it asking us? Question number 10 is the equilibrium constant for the following reaction. So we have to find Kc for the following reaction. What's the reaction? Reaction is K2CO3 aqueous plus BaSO4 solid is in equilibrium with BaCO3, which is again solid, and K2SO4, and K2SO4, which is aqueous. Now you can see that here easily. So options are, what are the options you have? CO3 2 minus. Options are CO3 2 minus divided by SO4 2 minus. Option 2 for this is K2CO3 molar concentration divided by molar concentration of K2SO4. Option 3 is BaSO4, molar concentration of BaSO4 divided by molar concentration of CO3 2 minus. And fourth option is SO4 2 minus by molar concentration of CO3 2 minus. Right? We have to find out Kc for this reaction. We already know the concentration of solid in any equilibrium equation is taken to be unity. So once you take Kc, so what will be Kc equal to? Molar concentration of products. What are the products? We have BaCO3, which is solid. Then you have got K2 SO4, which is aqueous, divided by K2CO3, which is again aqueous, and molar concentration of BaSO4, which is solid. Because these two are solid, so they will be off. Their concentration will be unity. So the correct value of Kc will be K2SO4 aqueous divided by K2CO3. K2SO4 divided by K2SO4 divided by K2CO3. Right? K2SO4 So I have given the options. Options are CO3 2 minus by SO4 2 minus. Second option is K2 CO3 by K2 SO4. Option third is BaSO4 by CO3 2 minus. And option four is SO4 2 minus by CO3 2 minus. SO4 2 minus divided by CO3 2 minus. That is SO4 2 minus divided by CO3 2 minus. So I got two potassiums of same quality. So you got SO4 and CO3 as your correct option. So correct option will be SO4 2 minus by CO3 2 minus, because these will be found in dissociated form in the medium respectively. So in aqueous form, they'll be in broken form, SO4 2 minus and CO3 2 minus. So correct option will be option 4. Clear, children? Right. Let's move on to the next question. So question is, at temperature T, so we can see the question here, that's question number 11 for us. Right, question number 11 is, at temperature T, a compound AB2 dissociates according to the reaction. So what is the reaction given? Reaction is twice AB2 in the gaseous phase is giving us twice AB in gaseous phase plus B2, which is also in gaseous phase, with the degree of dissociation X. So degree of dissociation is X, which is small as compared to unity. So this X is very less compared to 1. That means wherever you will get 1 plus X or 1 minus x, you can make it equal to 1. Clear? Good. The expression for Kp in terms of x and total pressure P. What will be expression of Kp in terms of x and P total? Clear or not? So here P total is represented by P. Now what are the options we have been given? Option 1 is Px cube divided by 2. Option 2 is Px square divided by 3. Option 3 is Px cube divided by 3. And fourth option is Px square divided by 2. These are the four options given to us. Now you can see here, the total number of moles here are 3 and total number of moles here are 2. So according to the question that I solved yesterday, delta N equals to 1. So because delta N equals to 1, there will be one pressure term in the numerator. So you got P here, P here, P here, P here. That means this rule will not work here. You will not be able to solve the question on the basis of units here. So you need to go in a deeper detail to solve this question clearly. Yes? Good. Let us see this equation first of all and see the degree of dissociation and other values respectively. First of all, children, let us write down the Kp value. So Kp for this will be what? P square of AB according to mole fraction equation into P of B2 divided by what? P of AB2 whole square raised by the power equal to their stoichiometric coefficients. Also, we can write down what will be pressure of AB equal to. It will be mole fraction of AB, yes, into P whole square into, according to Dalton's law, pressure exerted by any component in the mixture, non-reacting gases, is equal to the mole fraction of that gas into P total. It is square value into P, mole fraction of B2 into P divided by what? Mole fraction of AB2 into P raised by the power 2. This is the general expression that we have. So we have to put the values of mole fraction in this equation to get the value of Kp. So to get the mole fraction, we will just break this into ice rule, which I have told you yesterday. So what's the equation we have? We have 2AB twice. This is a gaseous phase reaction. Gives us, children, what? 2AB, again gaseous phase, plus B2 gaseous phase. Am I clear, children? Right. Let us use ice rule. I, initial concentration, concentration after time t, and equilibrium concentration. Keep it in mind. Equilibrium concentration is total number of moles. Because when you have to calculate mole fraction, it is number of moles of that component divided by total number of moles. So equilibrium moles will be total number of moles. Clear? Excellent. So further, let us see. We have AB2, 2AB and B2. So what's the question asking us, children? It's asking us to find out the relationship between Kp, X and P total. So given expressions is here. Let us say, children, initial moles are 1. This will be 0, this will be 0. Yes or no? Correct. Then, concentration after time t, x moles are breaking. This will be x. This will be x by 2. Naturally, it is B2. It will be x by 2. So, what are the total number of moles in equilibrium? Total number of moles at equilibrium are 1 minus x plus x by 2. That means total number of moles are 1 plus x by 2. So you got total number of moles and you got individual moles as well. You can easily calculate mole fraction. So tell me, what is Kp equal to? X of AB, mole fraction of AB. Yes, have a look on the equation. Mole fraction of AB. How many moles? X divided by total number of moles. 1 plus x by 2 into P whole square into, yes, P2. How many moles? X by 2 divided by total number of moles, 1 plus x by 2 into P, denominated by mole fraction of AB2. Mole fraction of AB2. Yes, how many moles of AB2? 1 minus x. What's the total number of moles? 1 plus x by 2 into P whole square. Clear or not? So if square terms of pressure and square terms of pressure will cancel, one pressure will remain in numerator. That's what the expression is showing us out. Once you solve the question, children, wherever you get 1 minus x square or 1 plus x square, you can neglect x with respect to 1. You will be able to get your clear-cut answer. And you will see that on solving this expression, you will get Kp value equal to. So, what's the expression between Kp, x and P? You will be able to get Px cube divided by 2 on solving this equation. You got it? I'll repeat it out. So to find out Kp, I need partial pressure of individual components. To find out partial pressure of individual component, I need mole fraction of each component. That's why I use the mole fraction equation here. To find out total number of moles and the moles that have combined out, or the moles which are present at equilibrium respectively, from AB, B2 and AB2 respectively. Am I clear with the thought, children, here? Excellent. So have a look on this properly. Solve the equation out clearly and get the answer done. So 100% you will get your first option as the correct option for this. Clear? Yes. Let's move on question number 12 now. Yes. So whenever you get any doubt, just rewind the concept here, whatever is there. I have discussed it in full details. I'm not just going directly to the answers as I mentioned in my earlier discussions also. So we are reaching conclusion by logic here. Clear? Excellent. So let's move on to our next question. Good. So our next question here is, children. So we have question number 12. What's the question asking us? When 1 mole of nitrogen and 1 mole of hydrogen, I'll be sending these questions in terms of text to you as well. So you can have a look on the papers as well, and you can have a look on the solutions in the class itself. When 1 mole of nitrogen and 1 mole of hydrogen is enclosed in 3-liter vessel and the reaction is allowed to attain equilibrium, it is found that at equilibrium there is x moles of hydrogen. The number of moles of ammonia formed would be. So we have a general reaction, nitrogen, which we know is in a gaseous phase, plus 3 moles of hydrogen, I am balancing the equation directly, is in equilibrium with 2 moles of ammonia. Clear? According to question, 1 mole of nitrogen and 1 mole of hydrogen. So we have 1 mole of nitrogen at time equals to 0 seconds, technically initial concentration. And you got 1 mole of hydrogen, you don't have any moles of ammonia at the start of the reaction. And you are enclosing this in what? 3 liter vessel. So volume equals to 3 liters, correct. Is allowed at an equilibrium. It is found that at equilibrium, there is X moles of hydrogen. So at equilibrium, the number of moles of hydrogen equals to X. Very good. The number of moles of ammonia formed would be. So we have options are. So first option is. Our question is. At equilibrium, number of moles of ammonia would be. So that's a question to find out. Options are 2X by 3. Then option 2 is 2 into 1 plus X by 3. Option 3 is 2 into 1 minus X by 3. And fourth one option is 1 minus X by 2. So question is, when 1 mole of nitrogen and 1 mole of hydrogen is enclosed in 3 liter vessel and the reaction is allowed at an equilibrium, it's found that at equilibrium X moles of hydrogen are there. The number of moles of ammonia are. So you have been given options 2X by 3, 2 into 1 plus X by 3, then 2 into 1 minus X by 3 and 1 minus X by 3. Correct? Again, we need to find out the value of, we have been given the value of X. Let's have a look. Concentration after time T. I won't write 1 minus X because X value is already given. I'll write 1 minus N. N moles from nitrogen are combining. Then from this 1 minus 3N and ammonia will be obviously 2N. Hope you understood the point. Because the total number of moles of hydrogen are 3. So from 1 there is 3N moles of, from each hydrogen N. So from 3 hydrogen is 3N. Because from 1 mole of nitrogen only N is coming out. So equilibrium concentration needs not to be written. According to logic, at equilibrium, the number of moles of hydrogen equals to what? X. So can I write down, according to given question, 1 minus 3N equals to X? Yes, because at equilibrium, the number of moles of hydrogen remaining are how many? X. So I wrote it 1 minus 3N equals to what? 1 minus 3N equals to what? X. What are we finding out? We are trying to find out the value of N. So how can we do that, children? We can write down 1 minus X equals to 3N. Clear or not? So we can write down 1 minus 3N equals to X. So according to that, what will be N value equal to, children? What will be N value? So N value will be 1 minus X divided by 3. You got N value or not? Now tell me what we have to find out. Ammonia. Tell me at equilibrium what's the moles of ammonia? 2N. So number of moles of ammonia equals to 2N. So that will be 2 into N. What is N value? 1 minus X divided by 3. So correct option will be 2 into 1 minus X divided by 3. So correct option is 2 into 1 minus X divided by 3. So option 3 will be our correct option. You got the question? So we had 1 mole of nitrogen, 1 mole of hydrogen, initially no moles of ammonia. So I considered N moles to be breaking from 3 hydrogen is 3N, 2N. So I found 1 minus 3N equals to what? X. No need to take, because sometimes when the volume is given to you, if this volume is given to you, you can only use this volume term when you have to use molar concentration term. Here you are not using that at all. So because according to the question, 1 minus 3N equals to what? X. So you are solving for X. Then at equilibrium, you have how many moles of ammonia? 2N. N value has been found out. You can introduce the value, get the answer done. So this is a tricky part wherein examiner is trying to detour you from your original path. Otherwise, question is direct and straightforward. Clear, children? Excellent. Let's move on to question number 13 with respect to this. Should be a simple one. So I'll take 3 more questions from this. So we can conclude our discussion for chemical equilibrium. Ionic equilibrium is the next one which I'm going to discuss. Right. So we have a question. What is that? Question number 13 it is, children. The value of Kp for the reaction. So we have to find out the value of Kp for the reaction. Which reaction? Reaction is twice SO2 gas plus O2 gas gives us twice SO3, that's also gas. Very good. So the value of Kp is not to be found out. It is given. Kp value is 5. what will be the partial pressure of oxygen? We have to find out partial pressure of oxygen. Okay, good. At equilibrium, when what equal moles of, so number of moles of what SO2 equals to number of moles of SO3 at equilibrium. Hope you got the point. Options for us are 1, it is 0.5. Option 2 is 0.3. Option 3 is 0.2. And option 4 is 0.1. This is a good question. And you can solve it directly itself as well. Now looking on this question, at equilibrium, number of moles of SO2 and number of moles of SO3 are same. So you can neglect the pressure exerted by SO3 and SO2. Can we? Yes. So what is Kp? First of all, tell me. Kp will be equal to P square of SO3. Why? Because raised by the power equal to stoichiometric coefficient divided by P square of SO2 into P of O2. What do we need to find out? P of O2. Because at equilibrium, according to question, number of moles of SO2 equals to number of moles of SO3. That means pressure exerted by the two will be same. Because number of moles are same. If total pressure for the two gases is similar, according to Dalton's law, what's the statement? Pressure exerted by any component A equals to mole fraction of that into P total. So mole fraction is technically number of moles. So these two will be off because the pressure will be same. That means Kp equals to 1 by P of O2. What is Kp equal to according to question 5? So 5 will be equal to 1 by P of O2. So what will be P of O2 equal to? 1 by 5. So that will be, children, how much? 0.2. So the correct option for us will be, children, option 3, 0.2. Did you get it? Because according to question, it's already given. Pressure exerted by SO3 and the pressure exerted by SO2 is same. Why? Because number of moles are same. Question is not pressure is same. Question is number of moles at equilibrium are same. That means pressure exerted by the two will be same. Numerator and denominator will be cancelling off. So the net expression will be Kp will be 1 by P of O2. So you can find out P of O2 easily by 1 by 5. That's point. Am I clear, children? Excellent. So correct option will be option 3. Next question. A direct question and a simple and straightforward question. Please take a note of these things carefully. And if you want to revise, you can have a revision of this as well. Rewind the concepts clearly, children. Yes. Okay, let's move further forward. On to question number 14 now. So, if you are seeing that time is being taken for discussing of the question, you can see I am discussing all the basic logics here. It's not like solving question directly. I can do that, use equation and solve it out. There will be of no use. You need to understand what exactly is being done. Very good. Question next. For three gaseous equilibrium reaction, which are occurring at 27 degrees centigrade, what are the three reactions? So this is almost question number 14 now for us. What is it? So what are the reactions? Twice CO. This is gaseous phase. All are gaseous phase reactions. Gaseous phase. Twice CO plus O2 gives us twice CO2. This is first reaction. Second one, this is A. Reaction B is PCl5 is giving us PCl3 plus Cl2. Again, gaseous phase reaction. And third one is twice Hi is dissociating and giving you H2 plus I2. These are the three reactions given. The correct order of Kp pi Kc for these three reactions will be, options are, first option, A less than C less than B less than, option 2 is A less than B less than C, option 3 is C less than B less than A, and option 4 is B less than C less than A. Correct. So we have to find out correct order of Kp by Kc. We know what's the equation which relates Kp with Kc. So Kp equals to Kc Rt delta N. What is delta N? Change in the number of moles. That's Np minus Nr. Number of moles of products minus number of moles of reactants. For equation A, what will it employ? Kp will be equal, equation A, Kp will be equal to Kc Rt delta N. For equation A, how many moles of products? 2, and reactant is 3. So for equation 1, it will be 2 minus 3. That will be minus 1. So it will become minus 1. So what will be Kp by Kc equal to? Kp by Kc will be equal to, Kp by Kc will be equal to 1 by Rt for equation A. What about B? PCl5 gives PCl3 plus Cl2, right? So what is delta N for second equation? Delta N is plus 1. So what will be Kp equal to? Kc Rt raised by the power 1. So Kp by Kc will be equal to what? Rt. For which one? Second one. Yes or no? What about third? What about equation C? Kp equals to Kc. Why? Because delta N equals to 0. How many moles? 2 moles. How many moles? 2 moles. So Kp equals to Kc. Now tell me. Here Kp is Kp by Kc is equal to 1 by Rt. In B, Kp by Kc equals to Rt. So 1 by Rt is less than Rt. Yes. And here Kp equals to what? Sorry. Here Kp by Kc will be equal to 1. So where it is largest? 1 or Rt, because temperature is what? 27 degrees centigrade. So you can multiply the values. It is 1 by Rt. It is Rt. So 1 by Rt will be obviously less than Rt. So the correct option will be our option 1. That is A less than C less than B. Have a look. A less than C, which will be less than B. Because R into T multiplication, that is 27 degree, 300 into 8.314. You will get the value respectively more than 1. So A less than C less than B will be the correct option. Did you get it? Simple equation. Kp is equal to Kc Rt delta N. Find out the values of delta N and use Kp by Kc ratio respectively. Am I clear, children? Yes. Let us see the next question now. Good. Now, this question is with respect to Liechti-Lior's principle again. What's the question asking? Question is, last question from this equilibrium I'll discuss regarding Liechti-Lior's principle. That will be question number 15 almost. The equilibrium constants for A2. So we have A2 gas giving us 2A gas. According to question, the equilibrium constants at 400 degrees centigrade is how much? 1 into 10 to the power minus 8. And when I am increasing the temperature from 400 degrees centigrade to 600 degrees centigrade, the value of equilibrium constant is 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 respectively. Clear? So change of value, change of temperature, change of value of equilibrium constant. Good. The reaction is options are what? Exothermic, option 2. Endothermic, option 3. Maybe exo or endo, and option 4, delta H will be 0. That is no heat evolved. This is a good question. Now, what exactly has happened here? In this question, if you see, children, we have increased temperature from 400 degree to 600 degree centigrade. Equilibrium constant is increasing or decreasing. You can see 10 to the power minus 8 is changing to 10 to the power minus 2. Let us suppose this is K1, this is K2. So according to this question, K1 is less than K2 when T1 is less than T2, naturally. So when you are increasing temperature, equilibrium constant is increasing. Yes, equilibrium constant is the ratio of products by reactants. When can the value of equilibrium constant increase? When the products are increasing, then reactants. So if product is increasing, then reactant. Only then equilibrium constant increases. According to question, equilibrium constant is increasing by the increase of temperature. We know, according to Liechti-Lior's principle, when you increase the temperature, which reaction is favored? Endothermic. Endothermic reactions are increased by the increase of temperature. Equilibrium constant is telling you the same. Increasing temperature increases equilibrium constant. That means reaction is going in forward direction. So obviously, forward reaction is what? Endothermic. So option 2 will be the correct option. Clear, children? So these were some of the questions of typicalities which I discussed with respect to chemical equilibrium. Our next discussion will be the next part of equilibrium, that is ionic equilibrium, in which we will discuss about the concept of buffers, acids and bases, the dissociation constants, the solubility products and other values respectively. Am I clear, children? Thank you. Read hard and revise quick. Any doubt, you can ask anytime. Thank you. Have a good day.